This is Lisa from Mobile Tech Review, and this is the Samsung Jack i637 available on AT&T. As you can see, it's a lot more curvy than the original black jack. In fact, it looks a lot like BlackBerry Curve. Very shiny. We'll take another look at that later. In fact, we'll compare it to the BlackBerry Bold, which is bigger than the Curve, and to the Samsung Propel Pro, which is also a Windows Mobile smartphone, but with a slider. Otherwise, they're nearly identical. The Samsung Jack is a Windows Mobile 6.1 Standard Edition smartphone, which is the long-winded way of saying Microsoft smartphone. That's how we used to call it. It means it does not have a touchscreen. You're going to interact using the D-pad and the keyboard here. We like how the keyboard is in a smile configuration. It makes it easier to type, again, like the BlackBerry and like the Motorola Q9, in fact. Take a look at the side. You've got volume controls here and the power button. Nothing on the top. And here we have the Samsung Blade connector for USB charging and headset. Microphone on the bottom, and on the back, the 3.2 megapixel camera, and here's the speaker for speakerphone. The Samsung Jack has the sliding panels Windows Mobile home screen. You can see here, you can scroll through your missed calls. If we had appointments on here, we would see our existing appointments. You can create a new appointment. We've got AT&T's Express Mail service, a music player, photo viewer, and you can get the profiles right on the home screen, which is very normal. The Jack sells for $99 with a contract after rebates. It's $50 more than the Propel Pro. We're going to take one more look at that just so you can see the keyboards. Propel Pro is obviously a bigger phone and has a slider design and cost $50 more. Similar keyboard, and this one is a little bit easier to use, honestly. There's a little bit more doming on the keys, but this one isn't bad either. Thicker phone. They're both very chromey glossy. And the Propel Pro's camera is hidden behind the slider. It's a 3-megapixel with autofocus lens. So it really comes down to which design you prefer and how much money you want to spend between the two phones. Let's take a look at software that's on the jack. You have the usual AT&T pay-for subscription services like XM Radio, Music ID, that kind of thing. And we've got CV, streaming video service. And we'll take a look at that. We've got about half 3G signal right now. The phone has moderate RF. It's not fantastic. It's not terrible. It's enough of a signal to do well playing streaming video, hopefully. And we'll pick one. And it's going to hand off to Windows Media Player to actually play the video. Video fills the screen. It plays smoothly. The speaker's pretty good, too. Playback's not quite as smooth in terms of occasional jagginess as, say, the Bold, but it's still very good. The Jack has a 528 megahertz processor, so it's plenty of power to play video, and that's quite a fast CPU for smartphone edition. It has 256 megs of flash memory and 256 megs of RAM, so it's a pretty powerful little sucker. Battery life is pretty good despite the fast CPU so far. It has Wi-Fi and it has Bluetooth with a full set of Bluetooth profiles, including AT&T. It also has a GPS with the usual AT&T navigator, which we'll take a look at now. AT&T uses the data connection to download maps and directions as necessary. It's a $10 a month service. And we're going to take a look at where we are now. See how quick the GPS is able to acquire a signal. We're indoors. We're about 3 feet from a window. So that was pretty fast acquisition. I'd say that managed it in under 10 seconds, and it accurately located us. To move around on the map, you just use the D-pad. AT&T Navigator is powered by Telenav, and it has very good turn-by-turn directions, and it has a large POI database as well. And you can find by intersection, you can search in city, you can look for airports, and all that good stuff. Phone comes with Internet Explorer Mobile, which is an okay web browser. A couple of years ago, it was pretty impressive. Nowadays, web browser from Apple on the iPhone and Nokia kind of outshine it. But you can load third-party browsers, including Opera Mobile, which is an excellent web browser. So here it is, loading our website. It's a 320 by 320 pixel display. So we're going to do some scrolling to get around. So the layout's pretty accurate. And you can bookmark it. Right now we're in fit the screen mode, which actually looks quite good. And you can go full screen, like so. Like the previous blackjacks we know and love, keyboard shortcuts abound. For example, you can hit the FN and B keys to turn on Bluetooth. You can see it's working on it right now, and we'll see the little Bluetooth icon appear up here. The phone comes with Microsoft Voice Command 1.6, supports Bluetooth headsets, it supports voice dialing over Bluetooth headsets, and it does have Wi-Fi, 802.11bg. Again, this is the Samsung Jack i637 on AT&T, and this is Lisa from Mobile Tech Review. Visit our website to see the full review.